Welcome to Animalia Classes channel. Myself, I am Gunakar, Assistant Professor of Zoology. Let us learn reproduction in protozoa today. Reproduction is the process of production of young animals. It is also defined as a process by which the organism perpetuates their race. And it can be also defined as a cardinal or fundamental characteristics of organisms by which they produce young ones of their own species or own race. So we learn that reproduction is the process of continuation of one's race or kind in the nature. Protozoans use two types of reproduction. They reproduce asexually as well as sexually. In the asexual reproduction, sex cells or gametes are not involved. The reproduction has been take place only from one parent and no sex cells are involved, no gametes are involved. Whereas in the sexual reproduction, the males and female gametes are produced and these male and female gametes fuse during the process of fertilization and a zygote is formed. When the zygote undergoes development and it results in the formation of new organism. As I said, reproduction in protozoa can be classified into two types, asexual and as well as sexual. So reproduction from only one parent, that type of reproduction is called asexual reproduction, and no gametes are formed, no gametes are fused. This asexual reproduction is of many types: binary fission, multiple fission, plasmotomy, and budding. Whereas sexual reproduction, this reproduction takes place by the union of a male and female gametes to form a zygote, and this zygote undergoes development to form a new individual. And this sexual reproduction can be again many types: syngamy, conjugation, endomyxis, and hemixis. So let us look at the asexual reproduction. Let us start asexual reproduction with the first method, which is binary fission. Binary means two, fission means division. Through this binary fission, parent cell divides into two. In this binary fission, first nucleus elongates and divides, where the process is called the karyokinesis. Then karyokinesis is followed by the cytokinesis, where the cytoplasm divides. Hence, one parent cell divides into two daughter cells. And this type of division generally takes place during the favorable conditions. And nucleus divides amitotically into two daughter nuclei. Then these two daughter nuclei moves to the poles, towards the poles. Then the cell constricts in the middle to form two daughter cells. So this binary fission can be of different types in various protozoans. When the binary fission takes place along the short axis, then that division is called as transverse fission. Best example, we can see this paramecium. This is, you can see paramecium. Then longitudinal fission, in which division takes place along the long axis. So here in this figure, you can see along the long axis, euglena, the best example, where that means most of the flagellates, they undergo longitudinal fission. Whereas the most of the ciliates, they undergo transverse fission. In addition to this, there is an oblique fission where division takes place along the oblique plane. You can see here in this serratium where the oblique division takes place, dividing the parent cell into two daughter cells. Here, in addition to these three types, an irregular fission also present. The best example is amoeba, So the plane of division is not specific. So in any plane, the division may take place. So the best example is amoeba. Along with these different types of binary fission, a special kind of binary fission can be seen in few of the protozoans, where a mass of protoplasm comes out from opening up the shelled protozoans and it secretes a new shell. Then this double shelled organism, one old shell, the other is new cell. This is the old shell and this is the new shell, where the protoplasmic mass is come out into this new shell and then it grows and then divides in between, so dividing the cell into two organisms. This can be seen in shelled protozoans, and the best example you can see is Euglypha. Coming to the next type of asexual reproduction is the multiple fission. So generally multiple fission takes place during unfavorable conditions, in which the nucleus divides repeatedly without cytoplasmic division, and this nucleus division of the nucleus results in the formation of numerous bits, where this can be called as daughter nuclei. Then cytoplasm divides later on, that is cytokinesis takes place, into so many bits as there are nuclear bits are present. So, and each bit of cytoplasm surrounds each bit of nucleus, thereby forming as many daughter individuals. So this multiple fission produces small cells and they grow into adults. Sometimes they grow into gametes, which require fertilization to form sporozoids, like in sexual reproduction that may take place. We will discuss that later on. That means this multiple fission, either it may lead to asexual or sexual reproduction. So many types of asexual multiple fission occur in different types of protozoans. Number one, sporulation, where the body of parent cell forms spores, especially during unfavorable conditions. To tide over these unfavorable conditions, all the pseudopodia in the amoeba are withdrawn and it becomes rounded and it secretes a hard shell-like structure surrounding it, and the spores are formed. And this type of sporulation can be seen, or spore formation can be seen, in other protozoans also other than amoeba, like monocystis and entamoeba. Then Schizogony is a type of asexual reproduction which takes place in Plasmodium, where the schizonts are formed, formation of schizonts, and these schizonts may be divided to form the other cryptozoids or merozoids in due course of time. Then Gamogony, formation of gametes, especially in monocystis. The other type of asexual reproduction, you can see Plasmotomy. This plasmotomy is very much important, where it is a special type of binary fission. It occurs in multinucleate protozoans. Plasmotomy, the word is derived from two Greek words, where plasma means cytoplasm, tomos means division. It means cytoplasm is divided without the involvement of the nuclear division. In multinucleate protozoans, cytoplasm divides into a number of bits, and each of these cytoplasmic bit contains few number of nuclei, and this number of nuclei is increased in each bit to its normal level, thus forming a multinucleate offspring. This means a multinucleate protozoa undergoes division of cytoplasm to produce a multinucleate daughter individuals. The best example we can see is Opalina. So here in this figure you can see a multinucleate daughter individuals where the nuclei can be seen. The nuclei are only distributed, they are not divided, where the cytoplasm is divided and thus nuclei are distributed. Then next type of asexual reproduction is budding. So just like binary fission, but in this budding, one individual is smaller, this smaller individual remains attached to the bigger individual. Sometimes this budding can also be called as gemmation. This budding can be of different types. It is simple budding where only one bud is formed. The best example is Verticella. Multiple budding where many buds are formed at the same time. Example, Succoria. Then exogenous budding. Buds are formed on the outer surface of the body. The best example is Noctiluca. Endogenous budding, endo means inner, where the buds formed inside the organism. Again, the example is Succoria. Here, exogenous buds, you can see in this figure, exogenous buds are formed. Now, the blue color buds, you can see here, the buds, they are formed on the outer surface of the body of the parent. In addition to these asexual types of reproduction where we have seen the binary fission, multiple fission, plasmotomy, budding. So, in addition to all these types, there is an endodiogeny, one more type of asexual reproduction, where two daughter individuals develop within the body of a single parent. After the formation of daughter individuals, the parent is destroyed. The best example is toxoplasma. According to some authors, the regeneration also comes under the asexual reproduction where the reformation of last parts due to injury or any other process, when some organelles or some part of a body lost, then again the reformation of the lost part takes place and the process is called regeneration. The best example is Stentar. Now coming to the sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction can be defined as two parent individuals, they take part in this sexual reproduction. Sometimes that means male and females may be present, maybe male and one individual represents male and female forms, that is male and female reproductive parts are present in single individual. And sometimes male and female deviation will be present. Anyway, gametes are formed in this sexual reproduction. After the formation of gametes, their fusion takes place. The gametes are formed by the process of meiosis or reduction division. Now, after the formation of gametes, they unite in the process of fertilization and it develops to form a new individual. This type of sexual reproduction is many types. Let us go one by one. Syngamy. It can be also called copulation, where union of complete fusion of two gametes of the same species take place to form a zygote. And the nucleus of zygote is called syncarion. This syngamy is of many types. If the fusing gametes are derived from the same parent, then that type of syngamy is called as autogamy. Example is Actinosperium. If the gametes are derived from the different parents and these gametes they fuse, then that type of syngamy is called exogamy. Some gregarine protozoans and some coccidian protozoans are the best examples. Next one is hologamy, where two mature adult individuals behave as gametes and they fuse. Example is Copromonas. Pedogamy, here two young immature individuals behave as gametes and they fuse. Example is Actinophris. So this hologamy is exactly opposite to pedogamy. Hologamy, where two mature adult individuals behave themselves as gametes and fuse, where in the pedogamy, two young immature individuals, they behave as gametes and they fuse. Here you should remember these two terms, hologamy and pedogamy. Then isogamy. If the two gametes, fusing two gametes, their behavior is same and they look alike morphologically, then these two gametes, fusion of these two gametes is called isogamy. That means two fusing gametes show many similarities. The best example is Elpidium. And of course, monocystis also. Anisogamy. If the fusing gametes differ in their shape and behavior, then that process of syngamy is called anisogamy. The best example is Plasmodium, where this can be anisogamy of Plasmodium can also be called oogamy, where there is a two types of gametes are present, macrogametes and microgametes, where macrogamete is non-motile, microgamete is motile. That means macrogamete stays where they are produced and the microgametes come to the macrogamete and unite with it. Coming to the next type of sexual reproduction is conjugation. Conjugation is generally, it is a characteristic feature of ciliates. It can be also called as amphimixis, and where two adult individuals from different clones attach temporarily. And after the attachment, the exchange of nuclear material takes place, and this attachment remains for several hours. And this association indicates a high level of specialization. In this conjugation, macronucleus breaks up and disappears. The micronucleus in each conjugant undergoes first meiotic division, then followed by two mitotic divisions, totally forming 8 haploid nuclei in each cell, where 7 of them disintegrate and the remaining one undergoes mitosis, producing 2 gamete nuclei in each cell. And one of these is stationary and is called the female nucleus, and the other is wandering or male nucleus. And now there is an exchange of male nucleus between two conjugants takes place. Then the male and female nuclei fuse to form a synchorion or zygotic nucleus. Post-fertilization nuclear division takes place. And in this way, a rejuvenation process occurs. In this conjugation process, sometimes conjugants are similar in size. Example, Paramecium. In this figure, you can see the conjugants, how the two conjugants from different clones, they move closer, they attach here, and how the division takes place, and totally at the last, the daughter nuclei, daughter cells are formed. If the conjugants are dissimilar in size, sometimes, and the best example is Verticella. So, attached conjugants may be similar in size or dissimilar in size. Next type of sexual reproduction is endomixis. In this endomixis, nuclear reorganization within the same individual takes place. Example is Paramecium aurelia. Generally, this endomixis takes place when the conjugation is prevented from occurrence. Now coming to the hemixis. In this hemixis, a small change shows from endomixis. Here, total nuclear reorganization takes place in the endomixis, whereas in the hemixis, macronucleus undergoes degenerative changes. The best example is paramecium caudatum. Thank you.